Now, I don't know if it's for everyone, but I just love the sound of rain. Very relaxing, if you know what I mean. What's up, you guys? Hope you're all staying safe and healthy during these times. Now, I don't know if it's just me. Do you find that you're just taking a lot more naps in your room? Because you're just always inside. The bed's always, well, my bed right now is behind me, but it's just always, you know, there, like a good old friend. A good friend that doesn't talk back. So in the spirit of us all staying home, what would be a nice way to spruce up the environment of the indoors? Now, I don't know if it's just me, but I'm what you call a craft hoarder, which means I hoard crafts and such. So I have a bunch of like frames that I just don't use, and I don't know why we have it, because yeah, I don't know, maybe just we intended to put something in it, but then we were like, let's not use these frames. So I thought, what would be a good way to use these frames? And if you were asking yourself that same question by hoarding a bunch of crafts, then this video is for you. So today we'll be utilizing some of the frames into some creative artwork put around your room. Honestly, I still love the sound of rain. And don't worry, just in case you were thinking, but what if I don't have the supplies? What if I don't have what you're showing? What if I just want to eat? Well, this video will solve problems 1 through 2. And the last one, always delivery or cooking. There's always more banana bread. And before we continue, don't forget to subscribe below here, here. Somewhere down below here. Hello! And just in case if this video wasn't enough, follow me on any social medias down below as well. Hello! I would say I post some interesting stuff. Maybe. Yeah! Now let's jump into the video. So to begin this project, take your frame and remove anything inside, such as the backing or any of the cardboard. But what if you don't have a frame? Well, that is a great question, guy in the back who I don't know. You could always just use a piece of cardboard and just cut out the center and just make your own border. Or a clever thing you could use if you have a clipboard. So just put your decide your picture right in, and then that's your frame. Bent. Bent. So the next step is to take your paint and just to prime the frame, just so when you apply the actual color that you want to add, the color is a bit more vibrant than if you didn't add it. Yeah, get that paint in there. So now I'm showing you how not to apply the paint. If you apply it in this lumpy, clumpy way, then the paint will dry unevenly and it'll show in the final product. So this is how you should apply the paint, in 1 or 2 coats, just so that the paint can have time to dry and it's not as clumpy and more smooth. And the next step is to take the backing from the original frame, just to trace out the border, which can be adjusted by the thickness of your liking. I just chose the thickness of the ruler itself. And to do this, just take the ruler and then mark off around the perimeter of the paper, and then cut it. And here I'm using scissors, but in case if you were more mature or had someone older to help you, then by all means use an X-Acto knife. Now when your frame is dry, you can choose what color paint you wanted. So I chose this bronze color. Ooh, more paint. More paint. So now you get to choose what color you want. So obviously you can choose whatever color you want. Whatever color tickles your peach. Just remember, it's better to do 2 thinner coats than 1 thick coat. Look at the water after using the paint. Give me full like lush vibes. If only that was a bath. Now for the second part of the project, this is when you can create your own artwork inside. So here I'm taking watercolor paper and cutting out the same size for the frame. And now it may seem like I'm drawing nothing because nothing is showing up. Well, that's what we want to have for right now. So now I'm taking, well,
You should use a white crayon, but I'm just using a light peach crayon because that's all I had on hand. But any light colored crayon should work. And for this technique, the wax in the crayon will end up repelling the water from the watercolor, as the water and the wax won't mix, so that whatever watercolor you add on top won't get in the way of the crayon, leaving behind the cool artwork that you created. And now y'all are not ready for this magic! Bam! Oh, so it looks cool looking back at it now. So now I choose to do Monstera leaves because, you know, trendy. But of course, you can use whatever pattern you want. Dinosaurs, moons, flowers, anything you want. Now, this is a part of DIYing that I always find stressful because I have this warm-toned one that I made, but also a cooled one. Cool. Anyway. But then I have this one that's like more like gold yellow, and this one that's more like bronze or like brassy. Does that look better? Or does those two look better? Because I could go with either one, because since the brassy one is more cooler tone, so that it can match with the cooler tone of the blue one, and then since these are both warm, the frame and the inside, it can match. Or I could do like opposite. See, now it seems warmer because it's with this. I think I might go with this so the yellow can patch. Okay. I think that's the move. Bam! Okay, great. About to leave. And just in case you feel short on materials, well, no worries, this one uses magazines, which might be easier to find around the house. Now, you can choose whatever image you want. I'm just choosing one that's less of an advertisement and has less, ooh, Lily's ink, that has less advertisements and text. Some examples of magazines that are cleaner and have simple layouts are interior design magazines, fashion magazines, as they have less text and a plain image on top. So this saves the trouble in case if you don't want to say print an image online. This is an easy way because it's already printed for you and you just have to cut it out. So right here, I am indicating where you shouldn't cut the magazine. So in case if you want an image that's on the left side inside the magazine, then flip the page to the right and then cut on the right inner corner. And now that you have cut your page out of the magazine, now it's time to slide it in the frame. Then add any backings that the frame came with. Now the second part is totally up to you. So this is something called paint dipped art. So basically it creates the illusion as if you took the whole picture frame and just dipped it in paint, which I guess you could technically do if the paint was a certain texture. But if not, what I'm doing right now is marking off where I want the sections to go. So I decided to section off into thirds horizontally. So I had a top third, middle third, and a bottom third, just to mark off and block where I'm painting and where I'm not. We can't miss out. I'm done living life with the lights out. Die with my own doubts. Be free. Et voilà. And you guessed it, more paint. So now I'm just using white paint again, just to make sure that the colors later on are more vibrant. So that when I add the bronze paint, well, I kind of mix the bronze paint, bronze? I mix the bronze paint with some orange, just to give it a bit more variety. So that since it's such a lighter color, it can kind of still be nice and vibrant and bright. Ooh. And then once you're done with the paint before it dries, you just want to remove the painter's tape just so it doesn't get any stuck with it. Trust me, it happened to it before. And just in case if you notice any spots that aren't as nice, you can always touch it up. About to leave. Already passed. Now, just in case if you still think that you have a bit more limited access to materials, this next one is very, very simple. So for this one, I just used Bristol paper, but even simple 8.5x11 printer paper will work fine for this one. This one, for all you need is a pencil and maybe a marker. If not, then you can just use a pencil, totally fine. So this one's basically just like the artwork that I've seen online before. That basically, you take any word and enlarge it with the word and the definition. Now, I chose the word gratitude only because with everything going on, it may seem hopeless and dark, but just to stay thankful for the things that you do have, whether it's the water that's coming out of your tap or the electricity that's allowing you to watch Netflix every day, to really be thankful for the family and friends that you have, and even your health if you are in good condition, because these are many things that sadly we do take sometimes for granted. So I hope you found at least one of these ideas helpful to kind of spice up your room. It'll change it up while we're all in our rooms during this time. And if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe down below. Still don't know where it is, but somewhere there. Hello! And if you like this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up and check back later on for more videos.